Fair trial. The Constitution of India states that every citizen of the country is entitled to a fair trial. This is ensured in the following manner. That means whatever the trial which is being conducted in the court, that should be in a free and fair trial. It is the fundamental right of every citizen to be informed of the crime at the time of arrest. So it is the fundamental right of every citizen that they should get informed that for what crime they are being arrested. After arrest, he or she should be presented before a magistrate within 24 hours. So after being arrested, he or she should be presented in front of a magistrate within 24 hours. A person cannot be ill-treated during his or her arrest and trial period. So the person, that is the accused person, cannot be ill-treated during the arrest and even in the trial period. What an accused confesses in the police station cannot be used as evidence. So whatever the accused person is confessing in the police station, that cannot be used as an evidence in the trial. The court should give a copy of the charge sheet and the statement of the witnesses to the accused. So the court should give a copy of the charge sheet and the statement of the witness to the accused person, that is the culprit person. The trial has to be held when the accused is present and the accused can fight his or her case by presenting his or her witnesses. So the trial can only be held when the accused is present in the court and the accused can fight his or her case by presenting his or her witnesses who will support him or her. The judge should be unbiased and impartial. So the judge should be unbiased, does not give the decision because that particular person is related to him or her. After the judgment, if any party is not satisfied, they can appeal to a higher court. So once the decision is given by the magistrate, if they are not satisfied, they can appeal to the higher court. The public prosecutor. A public prosecutor acts on behalf of the state, that means behalf of the government. The judicial system in India considers every crime a crime against the state. So the judicial system in our country, it considers every crime which is against the state, that is the government. So the public prosecutor represents the case on behalf of the state against the person accused of a crime. He is appointed by the state. Public prosecutor is appointed by the state, that is the government. However, he is responsible for bringing about a fair trial and not seek the conviction of the accused only. So his responsibility is to bring out the fair trial, that means to give the best if that particular person is not a culprit and they are the police is using their power in order to frame them that he is guilty, then it is a duty of the public prosecutor to bring out the reality in front of the court. If in fact the court has interpreted the role of a prosecutor as a minister of justice who should place before the court all evidence in his prosecution, whether it is in favor of or against the accused. So the court has given a title to the public prosecutor, which is known as a minister of justice, whose duty is to place all the evidence in front of the court, whether the evidence are against him or in favor of the accused. The aim of the public prosecutor is to assist the court in discovering the truth. So what is the main objective of the prosecutor is to bring out the truth in front of the court. Based on the evidence, the court will decide if an accused is guilty or not. So based on the evidence given by the public prosecutor and the lawyer who is supporting the accused, which is known as defense lawyer, finally the court will decide whether the particular person is guilty or not. The criminal law consists of the law contained in the Indian Penal Code, that is IPC, as well as the special and local laws enacted by the central and state legislature from time to time, and the procedural law laid down mainly in the Code of Criminal Procedure 1973 and the Indian Evidence Act of 1872. So these are the acts which give the special rules and regulation how the central and state government will carry on the FIR process, the trial, fair trial, and so on. Last topic of the chapter, jail. Once convicted, the accused has to serve a jail sentence. The time he or she has to spend in the jail again depend upon the nature of the crime. So the duration of the time which they have to spend in the jail, it totally depend upon the nature of the crime which they have committed. If a crime is proved, the accused can be sentenced to jail for a specific period of time. There are different kinds of jail for different kinds of crimes, such as central jail, district jail, women's jail. So these are the different types of jails which are present in our India. Each jail is administered by some officers. A superintendent of jail look after the working of each jail. So a superintendent of a jail, his work is to look after each jail. The inspector general of prison is in charge of all the jail in an area. So the inspector general will look after the all the jails which are present in his or her area. Sometimes after serving a jail sentence, when a person is freed, he does not get accepted in the society. So if a person is they are in a jail and once they are freed, they are not accepted by the society. This might lead to frustration and he or she might indulge in criminal activities again. So as they are not accepted in the society, due to frustration, they can again indulge or involve in the criminal activities again. To prevent such situation, many jails provide the inmates with vocational training as well as meditation and other self-help program to reform their criminal bent of mind. So in order to stop these criminal activities which they can do again, the jails provide many vocational training and even different types of meditation and other self-help program so that their criminal mind can be removed from their mind. This way they are able to lead a dignified life once they come out of the jail. So with the help of this vocational training, meditation and self-help program, the person, once they came out of the jail, they can lead a dignified life. That means a simple life, and they can live their life peacefully. Fact box: the largest prison complex in South Asia, the Tihar Jail, is located in Delhi, which is in our country. Kiran Bedi was the only woman inspector general of prison in charge of Tihar Jail. So till now, only one woman was only the inspector general of prison, which is the Kiran Bedi. Remember it. In her tenure, that is time, she introduced a number of welfare programs to improve the lives of the inmates of the Tihar Jail. So during her period, she have introduced many welfare program in order to improve the life of the criminals who are living in the Tihar Jail. And with this, we end the chapter.